بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. إن شاء الله we continue with chapter 17, chapter of the intercession or الشفاعة. And still in the verse, قل ادعوا الذين زعمتم من دون الله لا يملكون مثقال ذرة لا يملكون مثقال ذرة في السماوات ولا في الأرض وما لهم فيهما من شرك وما له منهم من ظهير ولا تنفع الشفاعة عنده إلا لمن أذن له. Say, call upon those whom you assert to be associate gods besides Allah. They possessed not even the weight of an atom either in the heavens or on the earth, nor have they any share in either, nor there is for him any supporter from among them. Intercession with him profits not except for him whom he permits. And this verse clearly refutes the call of those who use the intercession or shafa'ah to commit shirk, to call unto other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to call unto the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, as we heard clearly from the verses before, that the shafa'ah is only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's owned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why people need to seek it only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that the shafa'ah is given to those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to honor, like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like the believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't accept the shafa'ah after his permission. He would give them the permission first. And he won't accept their shafa'ah unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with them. And after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with them, then they would benefit from the shafa'ah. So the disbelievers does not benefit them to ask others for the shafa'ah. They need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to worship him alone and to not to associate partners with him. And in this verse that we just heard, it shows that all the means where the disbelievers they attach themselves to, it would never benefit them. Why? Because the benefit that they need to seek, it's only come from these four things that we heard in the verse. These partners that they associate with Allah, those who they call for the shafa'ah, are they owners of what they need to intercede for? They are not owners. Even the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, does not own anything. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of all things. And the second thing, as it's mentioned in the verse, that وَمَا لَهُمْ فِيهِمَا مِنْ شِرْكِ, they're not partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are they partners with Allah? They have no share. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of all things. And number four, وَمَا لَهُمْ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ ظَهِيرٍ, that they there is for him any supporter. They're not supporters. They are creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the fourth thing is, وَلَا تَنْفَعُ الشَّفَاعَةُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا لِمَنْ أَذِينَ لَهُ. Only those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them the permission, then the shafa'ah will benefit them then. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not give the permission for the shafa'ah to someone that is a mushrik, someone that is a associate partners with Allah. He mentioned here, قَالَ أَبُو الْعَبَّاسِ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ تَيْمِيَ رَحِمَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى يقول, نَفَى اللَّهُ عَمَّا سِوَاهُ كل ما يتعلق به المشركون, فنفى أن يكون لغيره ملك أو قسط منه أو يكون عونا لله, ولم يبق إلا الشفاعة, فبين أنها لا تنفع إلا لمن أذن له الرب كما قال, ولا يشفعون إلا لمن ارتضى. فهذه الشفاعة التي يظنها المشركون هي منتفية يوم القيامة كما نفاها القرآن, وأخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه يأتي فيسجد لربه ويحمده لا يبدأ بالشفاعة أولا, ثم يقال له ارفع رأسك وقل يسمع وسل تعطى واشفع تشفع. وقال أبو هريرة, من أسعد الناس بشفاعتك؟ قال, من قال لا إله إلا الله خالصا من قلبه, فتلك الشفاعة لأهل الإخلاص بإذن الله, ولا تكون لمن أشرك بالله. وحقيقته أن الله سبحانه هو الذي يتفضل على أهل الإخلاص فيغفر لهم بواسطة دعاء من أذن له أن يشفع ليكرمه وينال المقام المحمود. فالشفاعة التي نفاها القرآن ما كان فيها شرك, ولهذا أثبت الشفاعة بإذنه في مواضع, وقد بيّن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنها لا تكون إلا لأهل التوحيد والإخلاص. he quotes here the sayings of Abu al-Abbas, Shaykh Salim Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, that the meaning of which, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly in these verses denying the shafa'ah of the people of Ahl al-Shirk, the intercession of those who associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in which they believe that the human beings own the shafa'ah, they have the power to make the shafa'ah, and that it fits the people of associating partners with Allah. All of this is all denied. The shafa'ah is only for the people of the tawheed, the people who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Anbiya, وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنِ ارْتَضَى, that the angels do not intercede for no one unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with these people that the angels would intercede for. Clearly mentioned that in the Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنِ ارْتَضَى, ارْتَضَى from الرِّضَى, that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would be pleased for them, and then as a result of that they would intercede with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, we learn from this there are two types of shafa'ah: shafa'ah of the disbelievers, the invalid one, and the valid one, which is to the believers. To the believers is the one that is mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that the shafa'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he mentioned the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the people will come to him, go from one messenger to the other, asking him, meaning the messenger, to intercede to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the day of judgment to start, and each messenger would refer them to another, to the next messenger, till they come to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam would say, I'm for it, and he would go under the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he would make sujood, so as long as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permit him to do that, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell him to raise his head and to ask, and he will be granted, and to make the shafa'ah, and he will be granted the shafa'ah or the intercession. And this is the major shafa'ah for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is al-maqam al-mahmud that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is given, and that is for the reckoning to start, not for people to enter Jannah. This is only for the reckoning to start. And also he mentioned the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the most happiest people with the shafa'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are those who say la ilaha illallah with ikhlas. The hadith clearly states that when the Prophet, when Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he was told by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the most happy people by the shafa'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the day of judgment, those who say la ilaha illallah with sincerity, they seek the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So what are the types of shafa'ah? Sheikh Fawzan hafidhahullah here mentioned six types of shafa'ah. Six types of shafa'ah that will be in the Day of Judgment. The first one, the shafa'ah where it's only special to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which is the shafa'ah to all the human beings in the Day of Judgment for the reckoning to start. Believers and disbelievers, because they would stand for a long time and the sun is closer to their head and everything, and all the human beings will go to one messenger to the other just to start the reckoning and the questioning and so on. So this is shafa'ah to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge among the people. The second type of shafa'ah to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his shafa'ah for the people of Jannah to enter Jannah. After the people, after the believers, they cross the salat and they pass all the stages of the Day of Judgment, they would be held outside Jannah, and the gates of Jannah will be closed, and they would be held there till the Prophet ﷺ intercede for them, and he will be the first one to enter عليه الصلاة والسلام, and people behind him, عليه الصلاة والسلام, the same way they were behind him in this life following him. So this is another form of intercession for the Prophet ﷺ. The third type of shafa'ah for the Prophet ﷺ, to some of the sinners among the Muslims, those who died in the state of Islam. Again, a disbeliever dying in the state of disbelief, shirk, no intercession for him whatsoever. It's only for those who died in the state of Al-Islam. So the third type for the believers, those who died in the state of Al-Islam, but they died in the state of sin. They had sins they did not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from. So either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive them, or they will be punished in the hellfire. So group of them, they deserve to be punished in the hellfire, but the Prophet ﷺ will intercede for them and they won't be punished. They won't be punished, although they deserve to be punished because of their sins. So this is a group mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. And there are sinners with major sins. The fourth type of shafa'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the shafa'ah, the intercession to some of the Muslims, those who died in the state of Islam, and they were sinners, did not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not accept their repentance, and they would enter the hellfire. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will intercede for them to leave the hellfire and to enter Jannah. So it's different than the previous type. The fifth type of shafa'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam into some people of Jannah, for them, for their levels to be elevated in Jannah. For those who already entered Jannah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will intercede for some of them, for their levels to be elevated in Jannah is many, many levels. Each verse in the Quran for a person to memorize is a level in Jannah. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will intercede for them, and there are many other intercessions for other of the believers, but this is for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The sixth type of shafa'ah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that is a special shafa'ah intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to his uncle Abu Talib. He's died as a kafir, but the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that his punishment is to be less, is to be relieved a little bit, that he's still in the hellfire, alhamdulillah. He's in the hellfire forever. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed verses in the Quran when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his uncle died in the state of Kufr, and he used to support the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and help the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he died in the state of Kufr. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I would make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unless I've been forbidden from doing so. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, مَكَانَ لِلنَّبِيِّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ يَسْتَغْفِرُوا الْمُشْرِكِينَ وَلَوْ كَانُوا أُولِي قُرْبَى مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيْنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُ أَصْحَابُ الْجَحِيمِ. That it's not for the Prophet ﷺ and the companions radiallahu anhum to ask for maghfira, for forgiveness for the disbelievers when they died in the state of disbelief. So the Prophet ﷺ stopped making dua for his uncle after he died. So in the Day of Judgment, he is in the hellfire forever, the uncle of the Prophet ﷺ. But he is the least punished in the hellfire, and it was mentioned in another authentic hadith that the least person in the hellfire punished, two pieces of coal would be under his foot, that as a result of that the brain will be boiling, and this is the least punishment in the hellfire. So this is, but this is by the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So these are six types of the intercession of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and there's the intercession of the believers, and it's mentioned in the authentic hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them the permission. The believers will intercede for one another. Those who they used to know, they would say to Allah, Allah, they used to pray with us. So some of them will be in the hellfire and some will intercede for them. So again, with the conditions that we mentioned.